President Obama, in 6 months, quadrupled the deficit with an $800 billion stimulus bill that quadrupled the deficit. And that was, in my opinion, the straw that broke the camel's back. And they did that without even reading it. Now, if our elected politicians that we send to Washington, D.C. do not take that oath of office strong enough to read the bills that they sign, then we need to bring them home. And that's what we're going to do, Republican and Democrat.
Well, the difference is between Bush and Obama is that when Bush came in, we had a balanced budget. When he left, he doubled the national debt. Let me tell you the other difference. When he left office, we were going into a Great Depression. Many economists believe that the only thing that could be done at that point was to run a big deficit to offset the cut in consumer spending and business investment. So you're right. Barack Obama did run up the deficit. He did it, many people believe, because he had to, facing another Great Depression. Your reaction?
Yeah, my reaction is we've got a bunch of overeducated, undersmart people in Washington, D.C. They don't live like regular people do. We pay our bills on time. We go to work. We live within our means, not like the government borrowing trillions and trillions of dollars from people who are could be our enemies.
So let me get this straight. You think the correct action for Barack Obama coming into office with a Great Depression facing him, well, you may disagree, you can certainly disagree, that his correct response was to keep the budget down, let the government just laissez-faire, let the business community and the consumer bail us out, let the free markets operate. You thought that was the right answer?
I believe the free market always prevails. I believe he should have cut taxes, released restrictions on businesses that have run our businesses overseas and jobs overseas now for decades.
What did Hoover do?
I wasn't around then.
Well, you know history, sir.
What did Hoover do?
He did what you prescribe right now, which is to do nothing, run a balanced budget, try to deal with it the old conservative way.
Haven't they come out now and said that FDR's policies of Keynesian politics extended the Depression by at least 7 years? What we're saying is that if we would have never gotten ourselves in this situation if big spending politicians hadn't have been allowed to run wild in Washington, D.C. while we sit at home and pay the bills.
Okay. Well, the only thing, you may have a theory there. I'm all for any theory that can be proven, but Franklin Roosevelt was reelected with all but two states. I think he carried 46 states in 1936 against Alf Landon. So whatever he did restored public confidence, and people believed in what he was doing to the point where Vermont and Maine voted against him. So your theory that somehow he deepened the Great Depression wasn't believed at the time.
Well, who cares what was believed at the time when it came out with the proof now showing that it is? I mean, you know, that doesn't give me a thrill
of my life. Mr. Dennis, the problem is that history shows that the Great Depression was about to turn this country into probably a revolution. The Communist Party was building up support, the Socialist Party, and what saved the country was the Democratic Party at that time did something, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Right? You disagree?
Well, they did something, absolutely, but it's very debatable whether it was really the good thing for the country. All we're saying, and I'm not going to get into, I mean, I don't care to, but I will debate about President Hoover, but if that's what you brought me here for, you're wasting your time.
I bring you for is when you're holding Tea Party meetings and condemning this president for taking dramatic steps to deal with the Great Depression that was facing us, and you're calling that socialism, whatever, and I'm just asking you, what was the alternative when he faced what he faced that was left over from Bush?
Bush left him.
Well, let's look at Bush. Bush did $700 billion in bailouts in TARP. Then he bailed out AIG. He did all that bailout stuff and then left the president coming into office on January 20th, facing a Great Depression. He took dramatic steps. Normally, no president should have run the deficits we've had this year. I agree with you completely. But your answer was do nothing.
And look at the success he's had. Since he signed the stimulus bill to create jobs, we've lost more than 2 million jobs. Look at the great success he's had. What we say is cut taxes, give us more liberty and freedom at the ground level here in the red states or in the flyover country, as you New Yorkers call it, and let us live our lives like we do. But the government doesn't work that way.
Well, basically, you're saying to do what Bush did, a big tax cut. And then lots of speeches about the free enterprise system.
A big tax cut with dramatic cuts in government spending and dramatic cuts in the size of our government is what we advocate.
Okay,
we just don't disagree. We just don't agree with your ideologies, Chris. It's not the fact we're racist or rednecks. We just don't agree with your liberal ideology. And in 2010, we're going to see what happens.
Well, hey, look, fair enough. But let me ask you this. If you think doing nothing for this new president to come in, I think there would have been a lot of Republicans on the other side, a lot of critics like yourself, who would have attacked Barack Obama had he come in and done the usual smooth sailing and said, we'll get through this, just hunker down. I think a lot of people believe that if he had done that, we would be in real trouble right now.
You know, that's crazy
worst
talk.
Trouble.
That's crazy talk. I'll tell you this. If Barack Obama would cut taxes and if he would reduce the size of government and secure our borders, I would have his face tattooed on my chest. And that's an open offer to President Obama.